Welcome back for the continuation of the disaccharides. Disaccharides already we have seen maltose and lactose. Now the third sugar, it is sucrose. Sucrose is also one of the disaccharides. It is naturally found in sugar cane. Mostly the rich source we require it in sugar cane. Also it can be called as table sugar. Okay. Now the sucrose double formula also, it is C sucrose. Sucrose double formula C12H22O11 on hydrolysis. On hydrolysis, and it gives out, that is glucose C6H12O6 and fructose. Fructose is also C6H12O6. Here it is glucose and here it is fructose. Okay, these are the two simple monomers that is formed out of these sucrose. Okay, here we already have studied what is the difference, but both are monomers. General formula remains same, only the difference with their functional group. A glucose that contains hydrogen group in the first carbon, that has got hydrogen group. Fructose that has got keto group, that is C11O in the second carbon. That is the difference for glucose and fructose. Okay, now how they are connected, how it is formed as sucrose, with the lactose-free linkages they are connected between carbon 1 and 2. Okay, now here first we shall write the formula for glucose and fructose, then we start connecting how it can be formed as the chemistry of sucrose. That is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon, C2OH, the first carbon, that is aldehyde group. And here the glucose is alpha D glucose. Glucose is alpha D glucose. Alpha D glucose, which means then there is a reaction with first carbon, fifth carbon. The hydrogen, that is the fifth carbon, will be written here, that is OH. So it will be alpha D glucose. If hydroxyl group on the first carbon, if it is on the right side, that is alpha D glucose. Here hydrogen, and here third carbon always hydrogen on the right side. Here OH, here H, here not H, but this oxygen will interact with this first carbon here. Okay, now this is structure of alpha D glucose. Then we write beta D fructose. Beta D fructose is connected. Beta D, which means the first carbon, okay, the first means functional group, that is second carbon. Because fructose always contains C double bond, but here this is beta D fructose. Beta D fructose. So which means the functional group that contains alcohol group, that is OH, is on the left side. That is beta D glucose and here H. Then this will remain the same, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon. So after releasing of the water molecules, how the leakage can be formed? The leakage is formed like this. This is the leakage. Leakage with the first carbon and with the second carbon, leaving this oxygen here, one oxygen. Okay. Now this is the linkage. What linkage? 1, 2 glycosidic linkages. Glycosidic linkages. Now listen carefully. One thing to understand. With the maltose and lactose, comparing with this sucrose. Maltose and lactose, they are also connected with 1,4 linkages, and one of the molecule they were having free aldehyde group for those reactions, ozone reaction and for the addition sugar reaction, they were having one free aldehyde group. But here in these two molecules, no free functional group, either no free aldehyde group or no free keto group. Both functional group are occupied in both the molecules. Okay. Now here this also is connected, and here this is keto group functional group, and this carbon also it is connected. So here no functional group is free. Either aldehyde group or keto group. No functional group is free. So now there is no ozone formation, and also there is no Prick salt reaction. That is, valent reagent, filling reagent cannot be reacted with this functional group of, because there is no functional group, and sucrose cannot react with these two reactions. So the sucrose, now this is the structure of called sucrose. You say now the sucrose, it is called as non-reducing sugar. Non-reducing sugar. Why it is non-reducing? It is neither having aldehyde group nor having keto group. No functional group is free for the reaction to take place for ozone, also for the Prick salt reaction. So that is why we call it, this sucrose is non-reducing sugar. It is non-reducing sugar. But lactose and maltose, they are reducing sugar. At least they are containing one free aldehyde group, one free aldehyde group, one molecule. So that they are reducing sugar, and sucrose it is called as non-reducing sugar. Why? Because that we have seen here, the place where the functional group are there, they are occupied. Because this reaction can take place.